Today's topic, couples who meet on dating apps headed for early divorce, study finds. I'm Darin.
And I'm Katherine.
Katherine, how's that headline catch ya?
It makes me sad because that's how so many people meet these days.
That's how people meet. So it's a good, let's figure out what's going on here. This is from a study called Relative Strangers, The Importance of Social Capital for Marriage. We're reading the outtakes, I guess, on NewYorkPost.com. I do have the entire study pulled up here and I went through a few things. So I'll share that with you in a bit. But any quick ideas on why you think couples might divorce more if they're meeting on dating apps? Any quick guesses?
Sure. Yes, I have a couple, but I'll start with this one. Maybe it's less how they meet and it's more the time. Like people, maybe divorce is now common now and online dating is more common now versus in the past, divorce was less common and online dating didn't exist.
So just more, it's more of a norm, you're saying?
Yeah. Unless, of course, the study is probably comparing all recent marriages.
So what they said is 12% of couples who found their significant other online get divorced within the first 3 years, compared to only 2% of lovers who met through friends. So that kind of blows up your...
Okay. Would you like to hear my second theory?
Yeah. Nail it.
Okay. Online dating, which I've never done, but maybe people who are doing online dating are relying too much on checking boxes. So can you filter out certain things? Do you choose based on interests a little bit too much compared to morals and values? Are morals and values harder to search for?
Okay. I think you're on the right track there. What they basically break this down is saying, there's a lot of social capital built up in meeting through friends, family, or even through like being out at the bar, because you're picking up on social cues from the people around them. So if you meet through friends, or you go over to watch the football game at a friend's house and you meet someone there, you're not, it wasn't set up. You just see how she or he acts with the people around them. And you're picking up on those cues, where if you're doing online dating, you're basically meeting a stranger and there's no other backup of like, how should I read this person? I have to trust them for what they're saying instead of the small social cues that we pick up through other interactions.
Right. There's no context and you're just going, yeah, I'm interested in this person because they're interested in hiking and tacos and they like the same music that I like.
Okay. I like that context. I think that sums it up well. Another thing was support. If you meet through family or friends, or you have mutual family and friends,
yes,
then you have like a built-in support group when things get tough and marriage can get tough sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah, I can.
Okay. So 12% of couples who found their significant other get divorced within first 3 years. Compares to only 2% who met through friends. Now, here's the good news though. Let me give you a good news. The higher risk disappeared within the first 5 years of marriage.
Well, my theory on that is because by then, by 5 years, your friends and family know him or her better, and you've become more of a group, more of a community.
That's exactly what the study says.
Okay.
So on the very last page, they're summing it up. That's basically what they say. The reason why it disappears within 5 years is the higher risk compares those who met online with those who met through family, friends, and neighbors. One strong possibility is the couples are marrying as relative strangers. Reliable information, long-term character of the person you're dating or marrying is quite obviously more difficult for the couples who met online without input. For online couples. Yeah. So it just breaks down. Like that's basically what you're saying. There's a bond besides just the couple. There's a bond of like community of the family and the friends.
Yes. Makes perfect sense.
Now I would say, I think something that I would be concerned about if a loved one, if someone close to me had met someone through a dating app over the last 2 years with what's been going on.
Yeah.
that they're probably even more isolated from their family and friends than normal. So the chances of you meeting the person that they met and the number of times you're meeting them has drastically dropped.
Yes, I agree.
So I would make a hypothesis that we could see the divorce rate increase if you met someone online over the last 2 years and you're not doing an intentional, deliberate job of getting together with family and friends.
Yes, but I think the unsolicited advice that I would give is just give it time, take it slow because of what you just said.
Well, so that's actually a really good point. Like, why rush? If we know that the risk disappears after 5 years, just have a longer courtship is what you're saying.
Yes, that is what I'm saying.
All right, let's leave it right there because that is a great takeaway. That's all we got on this topic in this episode. Thanks for listening to the Real Estate, Money, and Marriage podcast with Katherine and Darin. And when you're ready, here's 4 things that you can do right now. Number 1, make sure you're subscribed to this show, whether you're watching or listening. If you're watching, you can also click the like button, click the thumbs up button. Number 2, if you're a first time homebuyer, get a free guide, 7 costly mistakes homebuyers make. Visit costlymistakeshomebuyersmake.com. Number 3, if you're selling your home, get access to our Get Sell Ready guide and checklist. It'll show you how to get your home ready without spending a fortune or wasting your nights and weekends updating and remodeling your home. Visit getsellready.com. And number 4, start a smart moves conversation with us. Get clarity about what to do next, get your questions answered, your concerns taken care of, and an action plan customized to your timeline. You can schedule a call with us at smartmovescall.com or start a chat with us. Visit m.me/Persinger Group.